My name is Bernhard Reinhardt and I'm working as a manager for our consulting client services team in Munich. The perception of severe thunderstorm risk specifically in Europe has increased. I mean, people have known for quite a while that on average in the aggregate, severe thunderstorms can contribute significantly to the overall wind losses. But nevertheless, I think especially the perception of catastrophic severe thunderstorms has increased over the recent years. I think this change in perception has especially been driven by the recent events. So if you consider it, actually two of the three most significant severe thunderstorms event happened in the last 5 years. So that was Andreas in 2013, which cost nearly 3.5 billion euros of losses. And then actually just 1 year later, we had Ella, which cost another almost 2.5 billion euro loss in Europe. So when it comes to modeling severe thunderstorms, I think the biggest challenge is really data availability, and that is kind of connected to the scale of the peril. So if you compare that to other atmospheric perils like extratropical cyclones or hurricanes, severe thunderstorms are relatively small. We have developed a novel approach that really combines different information sources to create the best possible view of risk. We call it physical statistical hybrid approach. We use atmospheric reanalysis data, which really tells us where and when conditions were favorable for severe thunderstorms. We are actually the first ones to use a European-wide radar data set that provides us with an objective view on the risk, and that is also used to inform the model. If we talk about severe thunderstorms and clustering, you know, not only need favorable conditions for severe thunderstorms, but you also need kind of first initiation of atmospheric movement. And then once you have a first severe thunderstorm developed, this can then trigger secondary thunderstorms. So this is kind of a behavior that we also want to capture in the model because it will influence the loss distributions. So we've studied this behavior using radar data, for example, and from that we derived some statistics that are implemented in the model to create realistic clustering behavior. So when it comes to the coverage that our model provides, I think it is very comprehensive. It's basically exactly the same as our extratropical cyclone model. We model the same 22 countries. We model the same lines of business, the same occupancy and construction codes. The introduction of this model will really benefit insurers and reinsurers in Europe, since they now have a really complete and consistent view of the wind risk in Europe, all provided in one platform, and which is accepted as a currency for risk transfer.